Hi friends, you are welcome to Literature Simply, simple way to learn literature and language. Friends, in this tutorial, we are going to discuss about why literature or the significance of literature for the society. I already made a video on what is literature, which is also very significant to understand what is literature. And before watching this video, friends, I would like you to please watch the video on what is literature on Literature Simply. So friends, in this video, we are going to discuss about the various facets of literature, different perspectives of literature or why literature is significant. So let's start. The very first thing here I would like to share with you, friends, is that literature has a very prominent place since ancient times. If you go in the history, you find their literature or art, which is considered very significant. For example, we have ancient Greek literature. In the same way, we also have ancient Greek literature in India. For example, we have the Ramayana, the Mahabharata, and other forms of literature. So literature is very significant, and it is came from the ancient period. And nowadays, how literature play a very pivotal role in the society, here we are going to discuss. The very thing which is related to literature is that when we hear the word literature, various things come to our mind. The very first thing is that books. Whenever we hear the word literature, we think that literature is nothing but books. It is right, or we can say that it is absolutely correct. But what kind of books are there in literature is significant. For example, there we have novel, plays, dramas, and other books like collection of poetries, etc. So friends, when we go into the very deep of literature, we find there are different genres, there are different kinds, there are different types of literature. Poetry, then we have prose, then we have fiction and other genres also. So friends, this literature has a very great role to play in the society. Whatever happens around us, whatever happens in the society is reflected in the literature, or we can say that it is a very definition of literature, that it reflects what happens around us, or the literature is the mirror of society. So the things happening in society is delineated in the literature, and it is like the mirror. So it gives us the very image. Friends, literature gives us a point of view. It gives us a perspective or a thing that how we look at the things happening around us. So it improves our perspective. It improves our very point of view, and hence it becomes very significant for the individual. And it is not only significant for the individual, but we can say that it is a national identity. When we refer to a very significant treatise or a very significant book, it is a national identity. For example, India is known for its literature of the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. This is our identity, this is our literature, and it has formed. So it is significant for individual as well as the society and the very nation. So friends, literature has always evolved around a particular kind of thought. So friends, literature develops our point of view. It gives us the very taste of reading, the very taste of many things, that how we look at the things. So this is significant in case of literature. Friends, again, if you want to improve your language, if you want to improve your skills of language, and this is through literature. So literature has a very significant place in improving your language or improve your linguistic skills. If you want to learn, for example, English, you must read a lot of literature. You must read what is there in the literature. You must read poetry, you must read fiction, or whatever there is available in the literature. So it improves your all the skills. It improves your communication, your speaking ability, and the language skills basically. So literature is not only a very static thing in society, but it is a flow. So friend, why should we read literature? There are obvious many reasons. The very first reason is that, as Aristotle said regarding literature, entertainment. To get entertained, it is the very end of literature, it is the prime end of literature to delight people, and hence we should read literature. Whenever we find that kind of boredom, we generally pick a novel and start to read it. So this is the very strength of literature, and that's why we read literature. So there are other reasons, there are so many things which are included in the literature. It provides you knowledge, it works as a means of knowledge. Whatever you want to learn about, you find it in literature. As we have already talked about, it came from ancient times. So literature works as a history, as a philosophy, as a means of entertainment, and as a very counsel, or it provides us the moral counsels, it provides us the how we should behave in the society, what are the manners that should be followed in the society. Everything is included in literature. Just it is important that you should go there and find out that kind of literature. For example, we have the great Shakespearean literature. If you read Shakespeare's plays, you find many universal things in the Shakespearean literature. So he generally composed 37 plays, 154 sonnets and 2 long poems. So what is there in his 37 plays? So he talks about the human nature, he talks about the psychology of human beings and how human beings behave in particular situations. It is the basis of his literature, and that's why Shakespeare became so great dramatist in the world, so great poet in the world. And again, if we come to India, we find we have a lot of saint literature. For example, we have Sant Tukarama, and his abhangas are very famous in literature. What are those abhangas? Those abhangas are directly related to the behavior of humans, or the reformation in human society, or whatever there is bad in the society, it is commented by the Sant Tukarama, or he directly criticizes all these things through his abhangas. And his abhangas provide us the very knowledge of living, the very knowledge of survival, which is significant in the society. So you can take any example of great author. He provides you many things through his literature. And friends, let me again tell a significant thing regarding literature, that no great leader of the world is made without reading the literature. Every great leader in the world have read the literature from ancient time till today. For example, Mahatma Gandhi is one of the finest leaders in the world, and he is influenced by the great author or the great novelist Leo Tolstoy. Again, there are so many examples. So there we have Dr. Ambedkar, who is also influenced by the great literatures of the Western countries, and this literature have shaped his mindset, have shaped his the very thinking capacity, or we can say that he derived many things from the Western literature, and he put these things in his own literature or in his own books. So friend, literature is very significant as we think in different ways. So if we talk about the various types, some people are fond of reading poetry. Poetry is a very good genre, or is a very beautiful genre of literature. And in poetry we find there are very less words, but the meaning is greater explained in those lines. For example, we have Shakespearean sonnets. He talks about love, he talks about friendship, he talks about human behavior through his sonnets. Again, there are so many poems in English literature, and there are many poems in Indian languages also. For example, we have Hindi, we have Marathi, Tamil, or for that matter any language which is spoken in India. So these poems gives us not only entertainment, but it gives us knowledge, the very knowledge of various things. For example, if you think about the romantic period poetry, Wordsworth talks about the very nature and this coexistence of nature in human life. So these things we derive from literature. So friends, literature is very beautiful. If you start to read it, you find that the joy, how delightful literature is, or how the joy is persisted in that literature. So I will recommend you to read any literature. This is all about literature or how literature is significant. So friends, I have made a playlist regarding various types of literature, right from the question, what is literature, to what is poetry, what is drama, what is novel. So there are so many genres are included in that playlist. Please go to Literature Simply and find that playlist and watch videos on various types of literature to understand literature in detail. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, please comment in the comment box, share this video among your friends and subscribe to Literature Simply so that you can get updates on language and literature.